Why do zebras have stripes? In this modern era, which is the tail end of what is often referred to as the age of mammals, mammalian species can be seen thriving all across the globe. This diversity, the product of millions of years of evolution, is exemplified by specialized morphological traits, which ensured the continued survival of mammals in their respective ecosystems. Incredibly, amidst this spectrum of diversity seen in mammals, there is one emblematic trait, although not found in 100% of cases, that has remained particularly stable. Fur. In zoology, fur is actually considered to be a distinguishing feature of mammals, alongside warm-bloodedness, live birth, brain complexity, and milk secretion from mammary glands. There are obviously exceptions to these features. Naked mole rats and orcas, for instance, have no fur. And conversely, tsetse flies and ringed caecilians secrete a substance to feed their offspring that could be defined as milk. Returning to fur, this incredible adaptation has a multitude of benefits. Some examples being thermoregulation, body temperature control, pheromone production, communication via chemicals, and sensors, such as vibrissae, also known as whiskers. All these functions considered, there is one facet of fur that can be seen as relatively uninspiring: its color, which is often a variant of brown. Now, this isn't to say that mammalian colors aren't ever visually interesting, but when compared to birds, fish, cephalopods, and reptiles, one could be excused for saying that mammalian fur appears rather dull. This aside, some mammalian species do present some very intricate and objectively beautiful motifs of fur. The giraffe, for example, displays an unusual mosaic of colors which covers an already exceptionally shaped body. And, unbeknownst to many, there are multiple species of giraffe which each boast their own specific configurations of fur. The function of these unique coats is believed to be for camouflage, allowing them to blend in more easily amongst the trees, and for thermoregulation, particularly related to overheating. To elaborate, nearly every single one of these patches is supplied by a network of blood vessels that can independently be controlled. This means that blood in a patch that is overheating can quickly be redistributed to cooler patches, maintaining a sort of temperature equilibrium. Sticking to the African continent, and another mammal with very distinct patterns of fur can be observed: the zebra. The zebra is so recognizable with its striated coat that goes from its head down to its hooves, but also due to its black and white coloration, deviating significantly from the typical mammalian tones of brown. Much like the giraffe, there are multiple variations of the zebra coat, each a variant of black and white stripes, largely analogous to the different species or subspecies of zebra. Now, based on an understanding of the color palette of the savanna, and the knowledge that large predators cohabit with zebras, one may wonder, why do they have fur that seemingly stands out in such an unforgiving manner? Well, there are multiple potential answers to this question. The longest standing, yet now most criticized hypothesis, is that the stripes of a zebra provide it with camouflage from predators. The idea being, particularly in wooded areas, that the black stripes could be confused with tree trunks and branches, and the white stripes with light shining through the branches. Unfortunately, this concept only really works on paper when other factors aren't considered, and even then, it seems a little flawed. Firstly, zebras largely dwell in open plains, where trees are sparse and tall grass is, well, often not all that tall relative to a zebra. So this aspect already doesn't quite add up. Secondly, camouflage is most effective in discreet and stealthy animals, which zebras don't tend to be due to their noisy social nature and skittish behavior. Finally, the visibility of zebra stripes to predators varies enormously, with time of day and distance being important determining factors. Specifically, during twilight, when many predators begin hunting, stripes were shown to be difficult to distinguish at distances of 30 meters or more, despite the outline of the zebra being clearly visible. So, as camouflage goes, its effectiveness would require predators to already be very close, which seems rather paradoxical. Conversely, tigers, which move discreetly, inhabit densely wooded regions with tall grasses, and which often hunt prey with adapted colorblindness, are perfect examples of animals that truly use stripes as camouflage. The more plausible predator-based hypothesis is that predators like lions may struggle to pinpoint one individual to target when zebras are grouped together or when moving at high speeds. The idea being that the high density of stripes moving rapidly and randomly creates a dazzling effect known as motion camouflage that would confuse their predators out of hunting them. However, this suggestion, for similar reasons to the camouflage hypothesis, is also no longer considered a strong candidate for solving this mystery. Truth be told, the most likely suggestions for why zebras have stripes are not related to predators at all, with one suggestion being that it plays a key role in thermoregulation, and the other as a bug repellent. In terms of thermoregulation, The belief is that this stripe formation makes sweating more efficient, which significantly reduces zebras' chances of overheating. This supposedly occurs thanks to a temperature difference between the black and white stripes, the former of which getting up to 15 degrees warmer than the latter, a difference in temperature that is believed to create chaotic air movement around the fur, which helps heat disperse via sweat evaporation. In addition, the hairs that make up the black stripes contribute in another way to controlling temperature. During hot spells, these hairs stand upright, whereas the white ones don't, which seems to help in transferring heat away from the body toward the tips of the hairs. And, conversely, the black hairs stay placated to the body when temperatures are cooler, helping to retain heat. In terms of the stripes' bug-repelling abilities, the data demonstrating their effectiveness against horseflies, termed tabanids, has become fairly robust. A way this has been demonstrated was by counting the number of times tabanids landed on zebras compared to horses, and, per unit of time, it was shown that zebras experienced tabanids landing on them 4 times less than on horses. Moreover, an experiment showed that during an almost 5-hour period, zebras weren't observed being probed or bitten at all, whereas horses experienced 239 probing events within an 11-hour window. In another experiment, horses were dressed in either zebra pattern coats or black or white coats. At a distance, tabanids would approach all horses the same, but when it came to flies interacting with the horses, the zebra-coated individuals were landed on significantly less than either the black or white-coated horses. In fact, the success of this technique has led many farmers, particularly in Japan, to paint black and white stripes on their cattle to protect them against biting flies. So, how does this happen? Well, it's not yet clear, but high-speed recordings have observed that tabanids seem to fly faster and fail to decelerate when approaching zebra stripes. This leads them to fly over or bump into their targets, and more generally, inhibits them from landing in a precise manner. Scientists are actively trying to understand why this occurs. Currently, suggestions range from stripes disrupting visual cues necessary for controlled landings, to the idea that zones of consistent color are a preference for tabanids, which stripes do not fulfill. But, as of yet, no definitive answer has been made. So, as it stands, there are several hypotheses regarding the zebra stripe question, but presently, these last two remain the strongest ideologies. And, feud as they may over who has the correct answer, it is far more likely, much like the black and white stripes of the zebra, that these two contrasting views are in fact complementary. Which answers for now this zoological puzzler of a question.